amazing wildlife. The Philippines are home to a host of exotic and exciting species. The Philippine flying lemur has a bit of a misleading name. It is technically not a species of lemur, and it actually can't fly. What's up with that? Well, you'll be relieved to know that this beautiful species can actually glide for distances as far as 100 meters. How does it do this? It has a foot-long tail that is connected to its front legs with a skin membrane. The result is a monkey-looking creature with big bat-like wings. They also have clawed feet for fast climbing. As a nocturnal creature, it spends its days fastened to the side of trees, sleeping and resting. But at night, they glide from tree to tree, eating fruits, insects, young leaves, and flowers. Because fruit is one of the major agricultural products in the Philippines, the locals actually consider this fruit-eating lemur a pest. But that doesn't stop us from considering it a beautiful Philippine species and putting it on our list. Number 9, Philippine crocodile. Let's get a bit more dangerous, shall we? The Philippine crocodile is a comparatively small species of crocodile native to the Philippine Islands. As a freshwater crocodile, they can be found in lakes, rivers, ponds, and especially marshlands. You can tell a young hatchling by its golden-brown scales, but the species' thick scalene armor gets darker and darker the older it gets. Welcome to humans. Despite being a smaller breed of crocodile, they still usually grow 2 meters long. The largest recorded Philippine crocodile was 3 meters or 9 feet long. You won't find me getting near the business end of those teeth. Unfortunately, because of this fact, humans have been known to hunt and kill Philippine crocodiles. It doesn't help that their skin and meat can be sold for profit. Currently, the Philippine crocodile is a protected species. Let's hope that their number jumps back up soon. Number 8, Palawan peacock pheasant. This bird is drop-dead gorgeous. The Palawan peacock pheasant is known to be an elusive species of bird. But if you manage to catch a glimpse, you'll be rewarded with a great view of a beautiful shining coat of rich blue feathers. You'll know it by the distinctive crest atop its head and the male's distinctive tail feathers. Yes, the Palawan peacock pheasant is named after the peacock for a reason. While not as extravagant as the peacock male's lavish tail feather display when it fights off predators or tries to woo a mate, the Palawan peacock pheasant is capable of extending its tail feathers in a similar way. The plumage is covered in robin blue spots that resemble eyes and help to scare predators away. They'll also use this extravagant display in their mating rituals. Number 7, Tamaraw. The Tamaraw is native to Mindoro, one of the largest islands in the Philippines, and so locals generally call it the Mindoro Dwarf Buffalo, and this name is right on the money. The Tamaraw looks like, well, a dwarf buffalo. They are small and stocky, a gray-black color with a stout pair of straight backward-pointing horns. Even though they're small for a buffalo, they still weigh a stout 200 to 300 kilos. They're harder to do. A count in 2016 placed the wild Tamaraw count at only 430, placing it on the crucially endangered species list. They continue to be hunted by poachers for sport and meat, and human population growth is relentlessly threatening their habitat. Luckily, the most recent count places their numbers at 460. Number 6, Dinaga, bushy-tailed cloud rat. You might not think of a species called a cloud rat as an exciting species of wildlife to seek out, but in many ways, the Dinaga, bushy-tailed cloud rat, is the holy grail of Philippine wildlife. It is the rarest of 8 species of Philippine cloud rats, all of which are either threatened or endangered. First appearance only in the 1970s and wasn't seen again until 2012. That's 4 decades between sightings. It's no wonder that many conservationists thought the species was extinct. They are a tree-dwelling species of rodent that feeds on leaves, and they can grow up to 2.5 feet long. Because of the uniqueness of this critically endangered species, there, number 5, Busayan, warty pig. All right, back to the animals. This is another extremely rare species of animals driven from their homes by deforestation during the 1970s and 80s. Today, only around 300 of them live in captivity. They were named for the quote-unquote warts on their faces, but Mohawk pig might have been just as appropriate for a name. They can be recognized by the distinctive tuft of hair atop their heads, and that has been described as very Mohawk-like. Believe it or not, this floppy mane is grown by males every year to help them attract mates. But you'll also want to keep an eye on the sharp tusks that extend out from their faces. Yes, those can be quite dangerous, but that doesn't mean that their species deserve to be completely eradicated. Despite strict government poaching policies, they continue to be poached for their meat, which is considered a delicacy by some. Thankfully, the species is breeding well in captivity, and efforts have already begun to reintroduce them into the wild. Number 4, Philippine moose deer. What would you get if you took a tiny little field mouse and mixed it with a graceful deer? Why, the Philippine moose deer, of course. Okay, it's away on its dainty little legs. Like many of the other species on the list, the Philippine moose deer has suffered a blow to its population from loss of habitat and hunting. Like the warty pig mentioned just before, its meat is considered a delicacy. Number 3, whale shark. I will admit whale sharks live in far more places than the waters of the Philippines. After all, the ocean is a big place. But since thousands of them migrate to the Philippine Elasmo Branch Mecca from December to May, they deserve a spot on this list. Sometimes reaching lengths of up to 40 feet, whale sharks are the largest species of shark in the world. So large, in fact, that they have often been mistaken for whales, thus the name. But don't worry, they aren't after humans. They swim around close to the surface to catch tiny food sources in the water like plankton. Do a YouTube search and you'll find plenty of videos of scuba divers safely swimming around massive whale sharks as they meander around them in the deep blue. 2, Philippine tarsier. Chances are you've seen one of these small primates pop up on YouTube before. Their distinctive appearance gives the Philippine tarsier plenty of airtime on wildlife programs like our own. With their long, spindly fingers, compact appearance, and absolutely massive eyes, there really isn't anything that looks quite like the tarsier. In my opinion, it constantly looks like it's just seen the most shocking thing it could have possibly imagined. It is one of the world's smallest primates, and everything about it is built for nocturnal life, where they will too. Number 1, Philippine eagle. Once known as the monkey-eating eagle, the Philippine eagle is a powerful bird. In fact, it is one of the largest and strongest species of eagles on the entire planet. On top of its impressive size, the Philippine eagle has an impressive long arched beak and distinctively majestic long crown feathers. Move aside, bald eagle. Here's a bird that managed to keep its hair, and it looks truly regal. In keeping with its reputation for strength and superiority, the Philippine eagle also eats lemurs, snakes, and bats. But the best thing about the Philippine eagles is its success story. Not too long ago, there were only a few of these birds left. They were on the verge of extinction. But thanks to the Philippine Eagle Center, their numbers have sprung back from the brink and they've been saved from extinction.